Yes, so we were discussing about rolling motion. Rolling motion is the body is moving forward, the center of mass of the body is moving in a straight line, as well as the rest particles are moving about the fixed axis of rotation. Such a motion we call it as the rolling motion. I think we have started already. So rolling motion in which the body is moving forward as well is rotating, the other particles are rotating about the axis of rotation. So the kinetic energy will be the sum of the translational kinetic energy and the rotational kinetic energy. So the total kinetic energy in case of rolling motion is equal to translational kinetic energy plus rotational kinetic energy. Okay, we know that the translational kinetic energy is given by half mv square. The translational kinetic energy is given by half mv square. Okay, the center of mass is moving forward. So it will be the velocity of center of mass, and at the center of mass, the mass is the total mass of the body. We know that the center of mass is the point where whole mass of the body is supposed to be concentrated. So mass is the total mass of the body, that is the mass at the center of mass, which is the total mass of the body. And the rotational kinetic energy is given by half I omega square. Okay, now here I is the moment of inertia. Okay, we know the moment of inertia can be written as, in terms of radius of variation, let any rigid body moving forward, the center of mass is moving forward and the particles are rotating about this axis of rotation. Okay, so I here is equal to, from the center of mass, the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation, we call it as radius of gyration, which we represented by K. So K is the radius of gyration, which is the perpendicular distance between the center of mass and the axis of rotation. So I is equal to, the moment of inertia is equal to mass of the center of mass, where the whole mass of the body is supposed to be concentrated. I is equal to m into k square into omega square, where k is the radius of gyration. And how do we define it? It is defined as the perpendicular distance of the center of mass from the axis of rotation. Okay, now omega. We know that omega is related to the linear velocity. By the equations, v is equal to omega into r. V is equal to omega into r. Okay, so omega can be written as v upon r square. Okay, v upon r square in terms of moment of inertia, in terms of radius of the gyration, it can be written as v upon k square. On the next slide, it is the same manner. Half m into k square. Okay, and omega can be written as v square upon r square. This is the velocity of center of mass. Okay, half m v square, you can take it outside. So here, the rolling kinetic energy, that is the total kinetic energy, takes half m into v, velocity of center of mass square outside, inside the bracket 1 plus, this is outside, so k square upon r square, 1 plus k square upon r square is the total kinetic energy when the body is rolling. Okay, if the body is only in linear motion, if the body is moving forward, okay, no rotation, only moving forward, translational kinetic energy half mv square. Only rotating, half I omega square. But if the body is rolling, it will be the sum of the translational and rotational kinetic energy, which can be given by this expression. K is the radius of gyration. Okay, for every body, you can find out the radius of gyration, and R is the radius square of the radius. Okay, so half mv square, I we have substituted as m equal k square omega. From here, v is equal to omega into r. So omega square will be equal to v square upon r square. Velocity of center of mass, take it common. So this is the expression of the rolling kinetic energy. Okay, so if the body is rolling, it will possess both type of kinetic energies, translational as well as rotational. So the total will be the sum of these two. Note it down. Okay, next we'll derive the expression of acceleration of, suppose a solid cylinder rolling down an inclined plane. Okay, we'll find out the expression of acceleration. Which rigid body here we are considering? A solid cylinder rolling down an inclined plane, okay, without slipping. If it is only slipping, then it will be translatory motion, like we have done in laws of motion. Okay, acceleration of a block sliding down an inclined plane. If you remember, we have found the expression of acceleration of a block sliding down an inclined plane. That was purely translational motion. Okay, now here we'll discuss the acceleration of a rigid body rolling down an inclined plane. Okay, rolling down means it will have translational motion as well rotational motion. So write the next heading: acceleration of a solid cylinder. Which rigid body here we are considering? Solid cylinder. Acceleration of solid cylinder rolling down an inclined plane. Rolling down an inclined plane. Okay, without slipping means no purely translational motion. Only slipping means purely translational motion. Okay, without slipping. Okay, it is rolling down. Rolling down means there will be translational motion as well rotational motion. So the next heading will find out the expression of the acceleration of a solid cylinder rolling down an inclined plane. Okay, let's draw an inclined plane whose angle of inclination is theta. Angle of inclination is theta, and then a solid cylinder is rolling down. Okay, a solid cylinder whose cross-sectional view is seen from the book. Okay, you can see the cross-sectional figure. The cylinder is at the back of this board. So this is the cross-sectional area of the cylinder, which is seen in the figure. Okay, laws of motion. We have found out the expression of acceleration of sliding of a block down an inclined plane. Then we get a block, and it was purely sliding down. That is purely translational motion. Now here it is rolling down an inclined plane, so it will have translational motion as well rotational motion. So let's draw all the forces acting on it. The first force, weight of the cylinder passing through the center of this solid cylinder, mg. Vertically downwards. N is the normal reaction perpendicular to the inclined plane. The same way we are resolving the forces. Extend this line, if this angle is theta, this angle is also equal to theta. Resolve NG into components. Component touching theta is NG cos theta, and perpendicular to NG cos theta is NG sin theta. Okay, rolling down the rough inclined plane. Rough inclined plane means there will be some frictional force also. Frictional force acts opposite to the motion. Okay, so frictional force will be tangential to the two surfaces in contact, to the solid cylinder and to the inclined plane. As the body is rolling up, so frictional force is acting along this direction. Okay. Okay, what will be the net force? As the body is rolling down, the net force is mass into acceleration, which should be equal to the resultant of these two forces. M into A should be equal to resultant of these two forces. What is the resultant of these two forces? From the figure, we see that this acceleration we have to determine. Okay, acceleration of a solid cylinder. This A we have to determine. So M into A is equal to which force will be greater as the body is coming down, rolling down? Mg sin theta. So it is equal to Mg sin theta minus the frictional force. The equation is the same as we have done in laws of motion for sliding down. Okay, but here it is not a pure translational motion. It is translational plus the rotational motion. Okay, so now if we'll experience some torque, let's find out the expression of torque. Okay, as it is rolling down, it is rotating also, so it experiences a torque. Keep it as equation number one and leave it for some time. Okay, now torque experienced. We know that torque is given by yesterday. We have written few formulas in terms of moment of inertia. Torque is given by I into L of moment of inertia into angular acceleration. Okay, if you forget it, think of the linear motion. In the linear motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay, so in place of force, what is the analog to force? How? Analog to mass is moment of inertia, analog to linear inertia is angular acceleration. So tau is equal to I into L. Okay, now here you can see that there are a number of forces which are passing through this cylinder. Now which force is producing the torque? Which force produces the torque on this solid cylinder? There are a number of forces, L, Mg sin theta, Mg cos theta, frictional force. Which force produces the torque? This is the axis of rotation. From the center of the body, the axis of rotation is okay, this is the axis of rotation from the center of the body. Okay, now what is R1 here? Any distance from this axis of rotation. All the forces are passing through this center of mass. Torque is force into perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. And this torque is where I kept the torque, that is at the center of the cylinder. This is the axis of rotation. Force into perpendicular distance. Any force you see, normal reaction, what is the perpendicular distance? No distance. Okay, only you can see that the frictional force is at some distance from the axis of rotation. So only the frictional force produces the torque. Torque is force into perpendicular distance. Rest all forces are passing through the center of mass, through the axis of rotation. Force into perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation, for all these forces it is zero. Only the frictional force produces the torque. Why? Because it is at some distance. What distance? Radius of the cylinder. So only the frictional force produces the torque, which is equal to frictional force into perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation, which is the radius of the cylinder. Okay, so here you can write down. Okay, write this equation. Tau is equal to I into alpha, which is equal to frictional force into the perpendicular distance. And what is the perpendicular distance? R. So write down Only the frictional force produces the torque. Only the frictional force produces the torque. Okay, so from here, let's find out the frictional force and substitute it here to get the expression of acceleration. So from here, frictional force is equal to I into alpha upon R. Frictional force is equal to I into alpha upon R. From these two equations, you can see that I alpha upon R. Okay, as you have to find out the acceleration, linear expression of linear acceleration, that is alpha, you have to convert it in terms of linear acceleration. We know that the linear acceleration is equal to alpha into R. So alpha is equal to A upon R. So substitute alpha as A upon R. Okay, so hence the frictional force is equal to I A upon R into R, R square. So here we got the expression of frictional force. Substituting equation number one. Substituting in equation number one. Okay, and find out the expression of acceleration. You will get the expression of the acceleration. Hurry up, try to find out yourself. Substitute this frictional force over here. And this A has to be determined. Expression of acceleration. Try to do it yourself. So what do we get? M into A is equal to mg sin theta minus ia upon r square. Okay, as you have to determine this a, bring this a term over here. M into a plus ia upon r square is equal to mg sin theta. Okay, now moment of inertia can be written as mr square. Okay, now you find out this expression of the acceleration, or let it remain in terms of I only. Take this ma common. Okay, anyway we have to put the moment of inertia for a solid cylinder. Later on in the next step we'll do it. Here take this m into a common. Inside the bracket, 1 plus I upon mr square is equal to mg sin theta. Okay, take this m a common. Here it is 1. As we have taken m common, so here we have divided by m. M a inside the bracket, 1 plus I upon mr square is equal to mg sin theta. Cancel m from both the sides. So here you get the expression for the acceleration. Acceleration is equal to g sin theta upon 1 plus I upon m r square. It's the expression for the acceleration for any rigid body. For any rigid body which is rolling down, it may be a sphere, it may be a ball or sphere, solid sphere, anything. Okay? You know the value of I, you know the expression of moment of inertia for any body, you can substitute and try to find out. Okay, it may be a ring, it may be a hollow sphere, it may be a solid sphere, it may be a solid cylinder. Okay, now here the heading is solid cylinder. Okay, this is the expression, this is the general expression for any rigid body rolling down. Okay, now for a solid cylinder, we know that I is equal to half mr square. Okay. Now let's find out for a solid cylinder. Let's once again see how we got this expression. All forces passing through the center of mass, only the frictional force is producing the torque. The total force L into A should be equal to the resultant of the forces acting along the inclined plane, which should be mg sin theta minus frictional force. Okay, either frictional force, like in the laws of motion, we have substituted as mu into A. But here frictional force is rotating the body, is producing the torque. Okay, so frictional force you cannot write it as mu into n, as we have done in the case of laws of motion when the body is sliding down. Here the torque is produced. We know that the expression of torque is I into alpha, which is also equal to frictional force upon into the perpendicular distance of frictional forces I into n for, that is I a upon r square. Substitute it over here and you get this expression, a simple simplification, that is acceleration, you get it is to be g sin theta upon 1 plus I by m r square. Now for the solid cylinder. For a solid cylinder, we know that the moment of inertia about this axis is half mr square. Okay, yesterday I gave you two expressions to remember it. Okay, I for solid cylinder. Okay, because in the heading we are written to be solid cylinder, so we have to find out for the solid cylinder. For solid cylinder, it is half mr square. Substitute it over here. You will get the acceleration for a solid cylinder. Otherwise, this is the general expression. So, acceleration you get it to be g sin theta 1 plus half mr square whole mr square. Mr square cancels out. 1 plus half. Take the LCM. 2 plus 1, 3 by 2. So it is equal to 2.3 g sin theta. So the expression for the acceleration for a solid cylinder is 2 by 3 g sin theta. Okay, now let's also find out the expression for the frictional force for a solid cylinder. Okay, for solid cylinder, frictional force is I a upon r square. Okay, as we are doing, let's find out frictional force also. Frictional force is I a upon r square. Okay, for a solid cylinder here we are finding out. For any other body, this is the expression. Okay, but for a solid cylinder, I is half mr square upon r square into acceleration, and acceleration for a solid cylinder is 2 by 3 g sin theta. Okay, so here we have substituted I as half mr square and acceleration for a solid cylinder is 2 by 3 g sin theta. Okay, simplify it, r square, this cancels out. So what do you get? Okay, so what do you get? 1 upon 3 mg sin theta is the expression for the frictional force when a solid cylinder is rolling down. Okay, also find out the coefficient of friction as we are discussing all this. Let's find out the coefficient of friction also for a solid cylinder. We know that F is equal to mu into N. So mu is equal to frictional force upon normal reaction. Frictional force 1 by 3 mg sin theta. What is the normal reaction? See from the figure. N is equal to mg cos theta. From the figure we see that this is equal to mg cos theta. So it is equal to mu is equal to 1 upon 3. Mg and g cancel out. Sin theta upon cos theta is tan theta. So the frictional, the coefficient of friction is 1 upon 3 tan theta. Okay, so this is the expression for the acceleration for a solid cylinder. This is the frictional force for a solid cylinder. This is the coefficient of friction for a solid cylinder. Mu is equal to 1 upon 3 tan theta. Okay, so here we have found out for a solid cylinder. Otherwise, the general expression is this only. I is equal to g sin theta upon 1 plus I by mr square. Okay, if it is a ring, then what will be I? Mr square. Okay, what will be the acceleration? G sin theta upon 1 plus 1, 2. Okay, but here in the heading as we have written for a solid cylinder, so we have found out the expression of the acceleration, which is 2 by 3 g sin theta. Also, frictional force, which is 1 by 3 mg sin theta. Also, the coefficient of friction when a solid cylinder is rolling down, which is 1 by 3 tan theta. Okay, note it down. Okay, next, write a question.
Okay, first copy it down and then note down, write one question. Write down three bodies, three rigid bodies of the same radius, of the same radius, are rolling down an inclined plane, are rolling down an inclined plane which body has greater acceleration or greater velocity. The one which will have greater acceleration will have greater velocity or greater velocity when reaches down, that is reaches at the bottom of the cylinder, reaches at the bottom of the inclined plane. When reaches down, that is at the bottom of the inclined plane. Write down the three bodies are a solid sphere, a ring, and a solid cylinder. Okay, so here you have to find out which reaches the first. Okay, not with the greater velocity, which reaches first. Okay, cut down which reaches with the greater velocity. Velocity question, we'll discuss it later. Okay, because from the same inclined plane, other bodies will have some other velocity. We'll derive the expression tomorrow. Okay, for the velocity also. Okay, today you find out which body will reach first. The one which is having the greater acceleration will reach first. The one which is having more acceleration will reach first. Okay, more acceleration, it will take less time. Okay, this is the acceleration for the any rigid body. Okay, the first body is ring. We know that the moment of inertia for a ring is mr square. Find out the acceleration for a ring. G sin theta upon 1 plus I is mr square upon mr square. This becomes 1, 1 plus 1, it becomes 2. 1 upon 2 is 0.5 G sin theta, because we have to compare it. So let us write it in terms of decimal, it is 0.5. Okay, then it is solid sphere. For a solid sphere, we know that the moment of inertia is 2 by 5 mr square. Find out the acceleration for the sphere. G sin theta upon 1 plus 2 by 5 mr square upon mr square cancels out. So 1 plus 2 by 5. Take the LCM, 1 plus 2 by 5, okay, 5 plus 2, 7 by 5, that is, this is equal to 5 by 7. Okay, 1 plus, here you can find out, 5 is the LCM, 5 plus 2, which is equal to 7 by 5, upon 7 by 5, this can be written as 5 by 7. Okay, so 5 by 7, find out in decimal in order to compare with it, that which body is having the greater acceleration. Okay, 0.7 g sin theta. The next body is the solid cylinder. We know that the moment of inertia for a cylinder is half mr square. Okay, and so the acceleration for a cylinder is, we have already found out,
g sin theta plus 1 plus half mr square upon mr square 1 plus half, that is 3 by 2. So this will become 2 by 3 g sin theta. Okay, 2 by 3, this is 0.6 g sin theta. Okay, 0.5 is for the ring, 0.7 is for the sphere, solid sphere, and 0.6 is for the solid cylinder. So here we see that the sphere has the maximum acceleration, so it will reach first. So the acceleration of solid sphere is maximum, so it reaches first. Okay, then last which one will reach? This one, ring. So sphere reaches first and the ring reaches last.